That's right, guys. On Wednesday, Governor Shumlin announced 11 sites in and around Burlington are being tested for PFOA. Today, I spoke with a groundwater specialist. He broke down how the chemical gets into the drinking water and how likely it may be found in Chittenden County.
Over the past few weeks, Miles Waite has begun studying PFOA in more depth, a chemical most notably used in Teflon, but also in many other everyday products.
It's been in Scotchgard and stain-resistant fabrics. It's in ski waxes. It's in flame retardants. It's in the lining of microwave popcorn bags. So it's been used in a lot of materials.
But how did this chemical find its way into some of southern Vermont's groundwater?
From the stacks of the chemical factories that produce or use it. The atmospheric fallout, so small particles with this PFOA settle on the earth, okay? Then the rainwater comes, and because PFOA is so readily dissolvable, the rainwater will dissolve it and then bring it down. It percolates through the soil and eventually down to the water.
The epicenter of testing in North Bennington and Pownell surround former manufacturing plants. The hydrogeologist explains that even though the plants closed years ago, the chemical can linger for decades, not only in the water systems, but also in the body.
It gets into the blood and it stays in the blood in your system, maybe even continues to accumulate in your body, and that's where you get the health effects.
As the testing starts in and around Chittenden County, Waite says there is a chance it could be found.
Geez, because we're now looking at the parts per trillion, we're looking at microscopic levels, we might find that it's everywhere. So I'm curious to see that if we start testing in places like Chittenden County, where, you know, away from Bennington, whether we might find it in there, just because it sticks around the environment for so long, and it can migrate far from the source. So we might find it.
Waite also says the PFOA test is very specialized, and the state does not require it to be tested for in public water systems or personal wells. Now, soil test results from North Bennington are expected to be released in the next week or two. Waite says when it comes to soil, the standards and health risks are much lower. In the newsroom, Jennifer Sheehan, WPTZ News Channel 5. Back to you guys.